Okay, can you all see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Network devices. Everyone can,
yes.
Can hear me right?
Yes, sir.
So now you all mute, everyone mute yourself. Done. So now the first network device which we will be studying is repeater. Now what this repeater does is, this diagram explains what the repeater does. When a signal is sent over a long distance, let's say this is a long distance wire of, let's say, 100 feet wire. So initially the signal is strong, but as the signal travels over the distance, the signal becomes weak. The signal becomes weak over a distance. So we have to regenerate the signal. So at 50 meters, this is an entire 100 meter line. So at 50 meters, we'll install the repeater. So what repeater will do is, it will regenerate the weak signal and again make it. So what this repeater will do is, it will regenerate the weak signal and again make it strong. It will not amplify the signal. What is amplifying the signal? Amplifying means to increase the voltage of the signal. Initially, when the signal had started, it was of this height. The repeater has again made it to the same height only. It does not amplify the signal. It doesn't increase the height of the signal. So it just regenerates the signal. So a repeater operates first thing at what layer? It operates at the physical layer. What is its job? Its job is to regenerate the signal. Its main job is to regenerate the signal, and it is in the same network. It is in the same network. This entire is one network. This entire is one lab. So the repeater is installed in the same network. They do not amplify the signal. They just regenerate it. What does amplify means? Amplify means to increase the voltage of the signal. So if the voltage generated was of 5, then it has again made it of 5 only. It has not made it of 10, 15, 20. It does not amplify it. It just regenerates the signal. So how does it regenerate? When the signal becomes weak, they copy the signal bit by bit and regenerate it at the original strength. At the original strength. It is a two-port device. It is a two-port. See, this is a repeater. So the signal which was sent, as it passes over the network, the signal becomes weak. So it is sent to the repeater. The repeater will then regenerate the signal and again make it strong. So it has how many ports? It has the input port and the output port. So it is a two-port device. So it's over here. It's a two-port device. Clear? This is a simple device called as repeater. Next device which we will study is the hub. So we all know the star topology. We had discussed the star topology. This is how the devices are connected in the star topology. So in the center, this device is called as the hub. So if I number these machines in clockwise order, A, B, C, D and E. So if A has to send some information to E, it sends it to the hub. And now once the information comes to the hub, it does not only send this to E, it sends this information to all the devices in the network. That is called as broadcasting. When the data is sent to all the connected nodes, that thing is called as broadcasting. So what does the hub do? The hub does broadcasting. So we have broadcast, we have multicast, and we have unicast. I had made a differentiation between them. I'll just show it to you all. Okay, I'll just show you to you all what is the difference. Here, see, what is broadcast? You can imagine broadcast to be a WhatsApp status. So if you have 500 people in your contact list, that status can be seen by all 500 people in your contact list. That is called as broadcast. What is multicast? Multicast is sending a message to a group. So if you have 20 people in one group and you send a message to that group, that message is seen by all the 20 members of that group. That is multicast. And what is unicast? Unicast is sending a direct message. So when you do one-on-one communication, that is called as unicast. So what does the hub do? Hub does broadcasting. Means once, if I have to send the data from A to E, A sends the data to the hub. The hub then broadcasts this data. So hub provides minimum security because the data is sent to all the nodes. So it provides minimum security. So see over here. So it is a dumb device. It is not an intelligent device. It's like rumor, just spreading rumors. So whatever data this has sent, it will not even verify, will not even check any errors, will send the data as it is to all the nodes connected in the network. So it does not do any processing, it does not use any intelligence of its own, will just send, will just broadcast the data. So let's see some short note on this. So this is how a hub looks like. If you see the hardware, so these are your RJ45 ports. So you can connect the machines to these ports. So it, where does the hub operate? It operates at the physical layer. So we had seen the ISO model, right? We had seen the OSI model. So these are the different layers of the OSI model, right? Where does the hub operate? It operates at the physical layer. So the hub and the bridge, they operate at the physical layer. The switch, hub, and repeater and hub, they operate at the physical layer. Bridge and switch will operate at data link layer, and router will operate at network layer. So where does the repeater work on? Physical layer. Where does the hub work on? Physical layer. So it is, where does it work on? It was on the physical layer of the OSI. Multi-port repeater. The repeater was two ports. The above repeater was how many ports? Only receive from here, send over here. But you can visualize the hub to be a multi-port repeater. Means whatever data is coming from machine A is being sent to all the other machines. So it just regenerates the signal and sends it to all. So it is connected in a star topology. So to the star topology uses the hub to send, broadcast the data to all the machines. It is not an intelligent device. It will just merely act as a communicator. It does not do any processing. It does not do any error checking. Broadcast. Whatever data it comes, it will just broadcast it. And you can broadcast it to how many machines? So we have a 4-port repeater and we have a 8-port repeater. These are the number of ports. So how many ports is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is an 8-port repeater. We also have a 4-port repeater. So it is available in different configuration. And it has a single collision domain. And this works on half duplex mode. It works on, means when this machine is sending the data, other machines cannot send. It's like walkie-talkie. How the police communicate on the walkie-talkie? If one person is sending the data, the person will really receive. Once this machine has stop sending the data, then this machine will say, okay, data received. This is called as half duplex mode. It's called as half duplex mode. All the machines cannot send the data simultaneously because there's a single collision domain. There's a single, when one machine is sending, there's only one entry or exit door, you can say. So if we have a class like our class, you have only one entry door, that is called as collision domain. So if this machine is sending, only this machine is coming through the door. Other machines cannot come through the same door. When this machine has stopped its data, then only other machine can send their data. That is called as single collision door. And this type of is called as half duplex mode of communication. Security is very poor. As mentioned earlier, security is very poor because it is broadcasting the message to all the nodes. So all the nodes gets the data, and it is a LAN device. We can form LAN using the hub. So using this hub, we can connect 6 to 8 computers together. So it is a LAN device. And now we have types of hub. First is active hub. Active hub, they have their own power supply. So this hub will have its own power supply. It cleans, amplifies, and regenerates the signal. What does it do? Whatever signal it comes to the hub, it will clean the signal, amplify it, and regenerate the signal. Regenerate means who does the regeneration job? So it also acts as a repeater. It also acts as a repeater. And it is used to extend the length of the network. It is used to extend the length of the network. What is passive hub? Passive hub is just the opposite of active hub. They don't have their own power supply. They just relay the message. They don't clean, amplify, and regenerate. They will just relay whatever comes in goes out like a repeater. And it is just simple receive and forward. Simple receive and forward. So I hope you all have understood with hub also. The third device which we'll be studying is bridge. So which layer does the bridge work? As told earlier, it works at the data link layer. And it is a semi-intelligent device. The above two devices were dumb devices. The repeater and the hub. They are dumb devices. They don't use the intelligence. Whatever data comes, directly send it to the other machine. Bridge is intelligent, but semi-intelligent, not fully intelligent. So what the bridge does is, it has a filtering feature. It checks the destination address of the frame, and then it decides whether to forward or drop. So it uses little bit of intelligence. It will check the address, and then it will make a decision. It will use its intelligence to make a decision whether to forward or whether to drop the frame. So it uses little bit of intelligence, not entirely intelligent, semi-intelligent. How many port is a bridge? It is a two-port device. Now I'll show you how it is a two-port device. See this. This is, you can think, this is how. This is, you can think of the bridge. So these diamond shapes are the ports. How many ports does a bridge have? Port 1 and port 2. Now these are one machine and these are another machine. This is western cities in western Maharashtra, cities in eastern Maharashtra. This entire is one network. This entire is one Maharashtra network. So the repeater, the hub, the bridge and the switch, they all work in one network. Like in school, how we had inter-house matches. So all the houses were of the same school. Red, blue, green, yellow. They were from the very same school. And they would play matches against each other. And then at the end of the academic year, one house would be adjudged the topper. So the repeater, the hub, the bridge and the switch, they all work in the same network. Only router works between two networks. So there is inter school also. So if there is St. Mary's and Bishop's, these are two schools. When these two schools play with one another, they are not playing within the school. Now they are playing between two schools. So only the router is the device which connects two networks. Apart from the router, all the other devices which we are studying works in one network only. So this is one Maharashtra network. So cities of western Maharashtra, cities of eastern Maharashtra. Now these two sub networks, you can call them as your within a network, these are two small networks. Now this is connected to the bridge on port 1. The western Maharashtra LAN is connected on port 1 and the eastern Maharashtra cities are connected on which port? Port 2. So the bridge has a bridge table. So on port 1, which all cities are connected? Pune, Satara, Sangli. So on port 1, which cities are connected? Let's say the name of the city is acting as a MAC address. Pune, Satara and Sangli. And on port 2, and on port 2 of the bridge, which cities are connected? Nagpur, Akola and Amravati, okay? Now what happens is, in a bridge, when Pune has to send a message to Amravati, let's say Pune has to send a message to Amravati, so Pune will send its message to which port? Port 1. This message will be relayed to which port? Amravati is at which port? Port 2. So, from Pune it will come to this port number, and from this port number it will go to this port, and it will go to, this message will go to all the nodes on this network. So it is called as multicast. It is called as multicast. What is broadcast? The how many nodes in the entire network? 6 nodes. So if Pune is sending a message to Amravati, Pune will send the address to where? Message to where? Port 2. When it sends to port 2, it sends to the all the devices on port 2. Means it is like a WhatsApp group. So it is called as multicast. And once it comes to port 2, all the devices on port 2 will receive that data. So that data will be received by Nagpur also, Akola also, and Amravati also. So Amravati finally gets the data. So this is what a bridge does. It connects to sub-segments of the same network. It will connect to sub-segments but in the same network. Apart from router, no device is connecting between networks. They all are connecting within the networks only. So, where does this work? It works at the data link layer. It is semi-intelligent because it makes the decision whether to forward it or drop it. It makes this small decision, so it uses some intelligence. It is two ports. It is two ports as shown over here. How many ports are there? How many diamonds are there? One and two. Port one and port two. So, it is a two-port device. What is its function? A bridge is also a repeater. Whatever data has come from port one, it is sending it to port 2, but all the machines on port 2 will receive that data. So it is like interconnecting two LANs, two sub networks in the same network. It is also, it, what does it use? Multicast. See, when all the devices are connected in the, to the bridge, no, first, the first message bit goes, will go to all the 6 devices. So the bridge comes to know which device is on which port. So it will send a blinking signal which will activate the bridge. So a signal will go to this machine, will go to this machine, this machine, this machine, this machine, and this machine. Will go to all, it's like a hello world, will go to all the 6 devices. So the bridge will greet all of them. With this greeting, the bridge will know which machine is on which port. So for the first message, it will always broadcast. For the first time, send the frames to all the nodes connected to both the ports. So first time it will always broadcast, and once it has got now which machine is on which port, next time it will not broadcast, next time it will do only, it will send to the individual machine. So it can also do unicast. What can it do? Unicast. Next time the machine, the code, rather I will say multicast. So next time if Pune is sending to Amravati, Pune is sending to Amravati, it will send the message to port 2, and then all the machines on port 2 will get the data. So it is multicast. If Pune is sending to Sangli, then it will send to port 1 only, and all the machines of port 1 will get the data. So first time broadcast, second time multicast. Two collision domains. Two collision domain. How many ports over here? Two ports. So two collision domains. Reduce the traffic. Reduce the traffic by splitting the network into two segments. The same network, it works on the same network. Apart from router, all the devices work on the same network. So it is splitting the same network into two sub segments. Okay, understood with what a bridge does. Next is switch. So repeater and hub, they work at the physical layer. Bridge and switch, they work at the data link layer. The switch also works at the data link layer. Now what was the disadvantage of bridge was, all these machines, Nagpur, Amravati and Akola, are connected to one port, and Pune, Satara and Sangli are connected to one port. So if there were 10 machines over here and there were 10 machines over here, these 10 were connected to one port and these 10 would be connected to one port. what a switch does is each machine has its dedicated port. Each machine has its dedicated port. So a switch can be of 2 ports, 4 ports, or 8 ports. And each, okay, this diagram should explain, okay, see over, this diagram should explain it better. Each machine has its dedicated port. Pune has its dedicated port 1, Ahmednagar has a dedicated port 2, Aurangabad has port 3, Nagpur has port 4. Okay, these are some cities in western part of Maharashtra. And let's say these are the your cities in the Konkan part, Mumbai, Lonavala, Ratnagiri, Kolhapur. So these machines also have their own dedicated ports. What was there in bridge? All the three machines were having one port. Here each machine has its individual port. And port 1 is connected to all the other ports. Port 1 is connected to port 2. Port 1 is connected to port 6. Port 1 is connected to port 5. Port 1 is connected to port 7. Port 1 is connected to port 4. So all the machines are connected to each other through a mesh. Through a mesh sort of topology. So it follows the mesh topology. So thus the traffic is less in a switch. Traffic is always less because there is a dedicated route. So A to B, there is a dedicated route. B to C, there is a dedicated route. There is no traffic. There was a lot of traffic in where? In bridge, lot of traffic because all the three machines were on the same highway. And these three machines were on the same highway. So in this, there is less traffic because each machine is connected to other machine directly. So less traffic, thus the performance always increases. Less traffic, so high performance. Switch will always give you a high performance. It also performs error checking. So it is an intelligent device. Switch is an intelligent device because it will do the error checking. It performs error checking before forwarding. So it is not like rumor spreading rumors. It whatever it hears, it will not spread. It will first check, verify the news, whether the news is authentic. Then only it will post and broadcast the news. So it does the error checking. So it is intelligent. Above machines were, the first two were dumb. The repeater and hub were dumb device. They would just broadcast. The bridge was semi-intelligent. But the switch is an intelligent device because it performs error checking before forwarding the data. Thus it is very efficient. Thus it is very efficient and does not forward packets that have errors. And forward good packets only. So it will not forward any sort of garbage packets. It will only forward those packets which are good. So it uses its intelligence to check which packets contain errors, which packets don't contain errors. So it is an intelligent device. Okay. So it has a CAM. It follows a CAM table. So what this CAM table does is it gives you the port numbers of each machine. It gives you the port numbers of each machine. So Pune is at which port? Port 1. Ahmednagar at port 2, blah, 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 blah. So if Pune has to send data to Kolhapur, it will look in the CAM table. Where is Kolhapur? 8. So if Pune has to send data to Kolhapur, it will search over here. Okay, Kolhapur is at which? Port 8, and so it will send that data to port number 8. So Kolhapur will receive the data. So switch maintains a CAM table. Okay, it has multiple collision domain. It has multiple collision. How many port it has? 8. So we have 8 exit doors. So there will be lot of less collision. And it is full duplex. What is full duplex? Full duplex is mobile phone communication. When I am speaking simultaneously, parallelly, you are also speaking. You don't have to wait for me to stop speaking for you to start speaking. We both can start and we can both speak parallelly. So it is full duplex. So as a dedicated part from each port to another port, data can flow parallelly, simultaneously, and there as multiple collision domains. So port 1 is transferring to port 8 simultaneously. Port 4 is transferring to port 5. This all the transfer can take place parallelly. So it is called, which is in which mode? Full duplex mode. It maintains a content addressable memory table. What does it maintain? Content addressable memory. So it is called as a CAM table. This is a CAM table. So the first time it will greet all the nodes. For the first time it will send a blinking message, so all the nodes which are active will blink and will tell the switch, okay, we are in the network. So first time it will broadcast, and remaining time it will send. So port 1 will send to port 8. The message will not go to other nodes. So next time it will only unicast. So it is intelligent from where to send, and it can choose the shortest path also. So if I have to send a message from 1 to 8, I can choose the shortest path to send to 8. So I can, as the machines are connected in a mesh, so I can choose 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, or I can choose 1, 2, 7, 8, I can choose the shortest path also. So switch is an intelligent device. So first time it will broadcast, and other time it will always unicast. Speed is slow, as there are multiple ports connected, the speed of the switch is very slow. So if it is a wired switch, the speed is of 100 Mbps. Now is the time of gigabits per second. So in the time of gigabits per second, it is hearing speed of Mbps. So if it is wired, speed of 100 Mbps. And if it is wireless, the speed becomes even less. It is 10 Mbps. So speed of a switch is comparatively very less. Types is forward and store. So first type of switch is forward and store. What it does is stores the frame, checks error checking, and then forward. So it will store also error checking and then forward. So it is, performance is very good because it is doing error checking. So it is reliable. But what is the limitation? The speed is slow. It's like police has put barricades at the highway. So every car which has come, the police will thoroughly check the car. Will thoroughly check the driver, seating area, the dicky of the car, registration number of the car, the documents of the car. Everything will be checked thoroughly. So this will reduce the speed. The traffic will increase on the highway. So this is the disadvantage, because it is storing also error checking and then forwarding. Next is cut through. Cut through is opposite of store and forward. No storing the frame, no error checking, directly forward. So this speed is very fast, but it is not reliable because it can send error package having errors also over the network. So performance is good, but it is not reliable. Third is fragment free. What is fragment free? So what we do is we devise a middle path. So it will check, but it will not check the entire. So the police will check the car, but it will not check the entire car. What they will check is, you know, nowadays when you go to a fancy 5-star restaurant, they have this trolley, they put it under the car, and they record the number plate of the car. So all the cars which have passed by that door, the police has that data. They will not inspect the car thoroughly. So what this does is stores the frame, but error checks only the first 64 bits. It will not check the entire packet. It will just check the first 64 bits, and then it will forward. So the performance also is good, and it is reliable because the error checking has been done. And as it is not checking the entire packet, the speed also is fast. So this is the third type of this. And adaptive switching is hybrid. You can use any of the top three in any order. So it becomes hybrid switching. It can work as any of the above. Adaptive switching can work as part. Adaptive switching can work as your store and forward. It can also work as cut through. It can also work as segment fragment free also. Okay. Now the next is router. So I guess the time is elapsing. We'll stop the video over here, and we'll after 10 minutes I'll send you a new invite, and we'll record or we'll discuss router on that call, because I guess the meeting is coming to an end, so we can't stop in between. So we'll stop here and we'll start a new meeting with router. Okay.
Hello, sir.